Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MiniConda with Jupyter Notebook in our Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now previously I have already shown you how to install Anaconda. Now since many of my students were asking how to install MiniConda, so I am just making this video. So to install MiniConda, you need to first download MiniConda. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, just simply type MiniConda download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this conda.io is basically our first search result. So now just click on MiniConda, and this will be going to redirect you to this official site of MiniConda. Yeah. And now if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this button for Windows. So if you are using Mac OS or Linux, then you need to just simply proceed with these links. But I am going to click on that Windows button. So that is what we need to do. So you need to just simply click on this MiniConda 3 icon for Windows 64-bit installation. So just simply click on that, and this will going to start downloading our Windows 64-bit MiniConda. So it has rightly started downloading Windows 64-bit MiniConda. So I am just since I already downloaded it, just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this MiniConda has been rightly downloaded over here. And see, the file size is just 58 MB. Previously for Anaconda it was about 500 MB, and now it is just 58 MB. Right, so it is just MiniConda, so the file is also mini. So to install, just simply double click on it and just simply minimize our download directory. And now if you just simply click on next, you will get this license agreement. So if you have time, you can always read that. I'm just going to simply click on I agree. And now it's saying that whether we'd like to install for just me or for other users. I want to just simply check this I just me, and that is also recommended one, and then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation destinations, so keep everything as a default, then just simply click on next. And now it's telling that whether we like to also register this MiniConda with Python 3.9. since I don't have Python installed on my machine, I'm going to simply going to check this. But if you have previously installed Python, then you need to just simply check that, and then you need to just simply proceed with that. But I am going to just simply check that and then just simply click on install. Now as you can clearly see, it has rightly started installing. So this is going to take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing MiniConda. Yeah, so welcome back. And now as you can clearly see, our MiniConda has been rightly installed. So just simply click on next. And now it's telling that is completely finished our installation of MiniConda. So just simply click on finish. So this is going to redirect you to your browser. It will going to show us some tutorials and all. So if you just simply click on here, you'll be getting this installation success, and you'll be getting some tutorials. So if you just want to watch that tutorial, you can always watch that. But I am going to just simply demonstrate how to install Jupyter, and then I'm also going to write a simple code snippet. So for that, you need to just simply go to your this C directory, then users, and then you need to just simply go you'll be going to find your name over here. So just simply go inside that folder. And then if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this MiniConda 3, right? You'll be getting that. So just simply go inside that folder, and then you need to just simply go inside that scripts folder, right? So now we are basically inside the scripts folder. You need to just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. And now you need to just simply click on this search icon, and here you need to just simply type environ, and you'll be getting edit system environment variables. So just simply click on that, and then you need to just simply click on environment variables. This will going to open this environment variables window, and here you'll be getting this path. So just in a simple click that and then edit. And now just simply click on new and then right click on it and paste. So we have rightly pasted our path. And then if you just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now let us first simply cancel our scripts. And now if you just again simply click on this tool and here just simply type CMD, then enter, you'll be getting your command prompt rightly open over here. Now you need to just simply type simple this command called activate base. Yeah, then enter. And you can clearly see your base has been, you know, rightly activated. And now we are basically going to install our Jupyter notebook, right? So for that you need to just simply type conda, then space install, then space Jupyter, then enter. And this will, you know, going to start installing our Jupyter. But before that, it will, you know, going to first download our Jupyter from internet. So for that you need to have an active internet connection. Now just simply type Y and then enter to basically, you know, proceed with our download process. So you can clearly see it is now currently downloading and extracting packages. So this will, you know, going to download our Jupyter notebook from the internet. So you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation so that it just able to download our Jupyter notebook from internet. So this entire process might take, you know, a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after downloading Jupyter notebook and then installing Jupyter notebook. Yeah, so we'll come back. And now you can clearly see our MiniConda has been, you know, rightly installed along with our Jupyter notebook. So we can clearly see it's telling done, right? So our our Jupyter notebook has been, you know, rightly installed. So if you just simply click on this search icon, and now if you just simply type Jupyter, you can clearly see this Jupyter notebook over here. So just simply click on that, and this is, you know, going to start our Jupyter notebook. So our Jupyter notebook is currently launching, and you can clearly see our Jupyter notebook has been rightly launched. And now if you just simply click on new, then just simply click on Python 3, this is, you know, going to open a new Jupyter notebook window. And in here, let's say you want to write simple, you know, PHP script. So for that, just simply type, let's say print, and let's say you want to just simply print hello world. Right, so if you just simply write that much and then just simply click on run button, you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown. If you want to install any packages and all, you can just, you know, simply type pip command, and you can just, you know, simply write that package name, and then if you just simply click on that run button, this will, you know, going to install that package, and then you can subsequently use that package, right? So in this way you can easily install MiniConda, and then you can easily install Jupyter notebook. I have rightly shown you almost everything, and then I have also shown you how to run a simple PHP code snippet. So that's basically all about this video, friends. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.